How do you get interview recordings that make it look like you're in the same room as your guest? It only takes a few small tweaks, so let's break down exactly how you can do it. Have you ever been like me, watching a video interview and thinking, how the hell did they get such good quality remotely? Or maybe you've been watching one and thinking, how does this look so bad? Well, the likelihood is, if they've got bad quality, they'll be using a software like Zoom. And if it looks great, then they'll be using the lossless quality of Riverside.fm. Watch and learn how you can make professional looking content yourself. If you're watching this video, then you're probably interested in increasing the quality of your video interviews. So let me list out a few of the benefits so I can convince you. First, you'll set yourself aside from your competing shows. You might have seen the low quality Zoom webcam recordings from other shows and they just aren't as enjoyable to watch, right? Your audience will appreciate how good the content looks. They'll enjoy it far more knowing that the level of quality you bring will be higher than the alternatives. This also means they'll be more likely to click on your video interviews in future, rather than those that don't care about their quality. If you choose to use a software like Riverside.fm, your guests will thank you for how easy the software is to use, and you don't have to worry about any internet connection problems. Let's first talk about the setup for a high quality video recording. I speak about video setups in this video and creating a video podcast, but let me give you a recap if you haven't seen that one. For a high quality video recording, you should try to get the best gear you can afford. You can connect a DSLR camera to your computer using something called the Elgato Cam Link. This you can pick up for around $100. We've made a whole video reviewing the Cam Link, which you can see in the top right of this video. If you don't have $100 to spend, you can also try this $30 version from Amazon that gives strong results, but not in 4K like the Cam Link. For your camera, as expected, there are a range of different options at a range of different prices. I use the Panasonic Lumix GH5, but there are some good options under $1,000, such as the Sony A6300. If you're on a tighter budget and you don't have a DSLR, you can pick up a Logitech webcam for between $100 and $200 that records in full HD. When you're recording a video interview, audio is just as important, if not more important. In our previous videos, we've compared some of the best options across a range of budgets. The mic I use most often for my shows is a Shure SM58, which is an XLR microphone that requires an interface and will be in the shot, if you don't mind that look. Alternatively, you can connect a lav microphone to your camera using the mic input if you have one. To set you apart from just having a nice camera, try and make your set look as nice as possible. You want your show to be as visually appealing as possible. To make a professional looking shot, you need to add as much depth as you possibly can, which you can do with a few different techniques. Make sure there is some distance between you and the background. If this isn't possible because you have a small space, don't worry about it too much. Good lighting is essential for creating the depth. Try to get a large softbox that will give you a nice soft and diffused light. If you don't use a softbox, you're left with an unflattering image and harsh shadows. I use the Aperture 120D with the light dome, but you can also pick up a Godox SL150 for around $100 along with a softbox for $50. To further increase depth, get a small light, also known as a kicker, which will give you a subtle outline of your head contributing to the depth. Put some interesting things in your background as part of building your set. You can add various props that make your background distinctive. You can see in my background, I have a microphone on a stand as this is a podcasting and video channel, plus a purple light strip because that is the Riverside brand color. I also have a practical light in the corner somewhere over here. Finally, make sure there is no clutter. Often a background can get quite messy, like mine. So spend 5 minutes making sure the background is clean and tidy. Now you've got a killer looking video setup, we're gonna get to video recording in Riverside.fm. Riverside.fm records the video and audio locally in up to a 4K resolution, so you can get the full resolution from your camera and no need to worry about an internet connection. Then you can download the files on separate tracks to create your video interview show. Head over to the Riverside.fm dashboard and get your show set up. Let me show you. First of all, go to Create New Studio. Name your studio. Select if you can do audio or video or just audio only. Invite guests or participants if you'd like to, and you can schedule it using the schedule button there. Then click create show. You'll then make it into your studio where you can select your microphone, you can select your camera and outputs. You can also choose to toggle echo cancellation with headphones or no headphones. I'm not using headphones for this one. Once you're into your studio, you can change a lot of the settings. Head down to the settings toggle in the bottom left. You can change your inputs and outputs as selected earlier. You can change your recording settings, your resolution, and more. Also here, you can see the participants that are on the call. When there's more than one, you'll see more than one person here with their camera resolution, also the microphone that they're using, and then toggle their inputs if you'd like to. When you're happy with all the settings, you can click start recording, and then it will progressively upload this audio throughout the recording. Then once you press stop recording, your files will then upload. And then you can see here, my recording is uploaded and done. I can go to view all recordings and it'll take me to my download, which I can download here. You now have the synced full resolution files to download from Riverside and pull into your video editor. You can download the tracks from you and your guests to add into the template that you use for your show. So that's how simple it is. Once you have a strong video setup, you can let Riverside.fm do all the heavy lifting to get you beautiful HD footage remotely. Hopefully you found this video helpful. If you've done any video interviews, we'd love to see them. Leave a link in the comments section below. We're going to be producing a bunch more videos on this YouTube channel about podcasting, video interviews, and more. So if you want to learn more about starting and growing a podcast, make sure you subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications so you don't miss an episode. Thanks for watching.